Mouse picking refers to selecting units in a 3D world using your mouse. This process involves translating the mouse's 2D screen coordinates into 3D world space. In this movie, we'll build a mouse picking system in Stingray to interact with the units in our level. We'll tackle this using a node-based flow graph. However, if you're familiar with Lua, you can also use this sample code from the Stingray help as reference. To get started, go to File Project Manager. Create a new project using the empty template. Rename it Mouse Picking and store it in a local folder. Stingray restarts and compiles your new project along with the included assets. Open your project folder from the asset browser. Copy the content and script folders from the files provided with this movie into your local folder. When this is done, go to Edit, Level Testing, Refresh to recompile your project with the newly copied assets. Open the level Mouse Picking. Click the green play button to test it. You can orbit around the level by dragging with the right mouse button. However, this isn't very intuitive since the cursor is hidden. Press the Escape key to return to the Stingray editor. To show the mouse cursor, we need to use the following Lua command. We could add this command directly to the project Lua file located in your local script folder. This Lua file is part of the project resources that Stingray loads when the game runs. You can find more information on how to use this project file in the Stingray help. However, for the scope of this tutorial, we'll instead execute this Lua command within Flow. Go to the Level Flow tab. This flow graph controls the active camera's orbit using a mouse input. You can learn more about this camera orbit constraint in the Controlling Game Cameras in Stingray tutorial series. Create a script doString node and connect it to the sequence node's out1 port. Enter the following Lua command. This node will execute it as a string. Test your level. The cursor is now visible, but it can't go outside the test level window's border. You can fix this using the following Lua command. Add it to the script doString node, and then test your level again to compare. To pick units using this mouse cursor, we need to cast a 3D ray in the level from our camera based on the cursor's position. If that ray collides with a unit's physics actor, then that unit is picked. First, duplicate this mouse axis node. Make sure you change its axis name port from mouse to cursor. This is because the mouse axis returns a position delta, while the cursor axis returns an absolute position, which is what we need. Next, create a raycast node and connect it to the sequence node's out1 port. We want to use our camera as a point of origin, so connect either a get camera local position or get camera world position node to the from port. Next, we can obtain a direction vector by subtracting the camera's position from the mouse cursor's position. Note that the mouse cursor's position is in screen space, so we need to convert it to world space using a screen to world node. Set the node's depth port to 1 to offset the cursor's position from the camera in 3D space. We can also add a normalize node to this flow graph to strip out the direction vector's magnitude. The length port corresponds to the ray's maximum travel distance. Set it to 100 to make sure it can reach all the level units. To validate your flow graph so far, connect the Raycast node's hit and out ports to this debug group. Then, test your level. Move the cursor over the cubic structure to trigger a positive ray collision. The Raycast node returns multiple output values that we can use to add more functionality to this mouse-picking flow graph. For example, we can constrain a unit's position based on the ray's point of collision. In the Asset Browser, navigate to the Pulse folder and drag the Pulse unit in the Level viewport. We created this pulsing effect by animating the material's color and opacity channels using a sprite sheet texture. Use a Set Unit Local Position node to constrain the pulse to the Raycast node's position output. Then test your level. The pulse glides around the cubic structure based on the ray's point of collision. However, we also need to orient it according to the surface's normal. Create a Set Unit Local Rotation node. Then, use a Rotation from Vectors node to convert the normal vector output into a rotation. Make sure you connect the normal port to the up port. Test the level to validate your changes. We can also use the Raycast node to identify units and interact with them. First, connect a Set Unit Variable node to the Raycast node's unit port. Name it MouseOver Unit. Set the node's scope port to global so other units can access this variable. Next, go to the Level viewport and right-click one of the LED cubes. Select Open in Unit Editor. Go to the Unit Flow tab. We want to complete this flow graph to control the desired cube instance's mouse over and mouse out states, as well as trigger its animation clip on a mouse press. First, create a Get Unit Variable node to retrieve the mouse over unit global variable we just created. Connect it to a Compare Objects node. Use the Unit Spawn node's unit port as the comparison object. Connect the Compare Objects node to the MouseOver State Flow Subroutine node so it triggers a MouseOver when both objects are the same and a MouseOut if they are not. Connect the Compare Objects node to the Level Update node, then save the unit flow and test your level. Repeat this process to trigger the animation clip for the selected cube only. With the techniques you learned in this movie, you can design your next puzzle or strategy game using this node-based mouse-picking system.